When looking at this bag of full beauty products or empty beauty products that I have here, that it's for me so heavy and so full, I think about two things. The first one, that I'm fulfilling what I wanted to do this year in regards to my makeup collection, which was shop less and shop my stash more and use the things and love the things that I have. And I'm happy that I always shop in my collection for things that I need and that I make it into a private project to finish them and rotate my collection instead of purchasing new things. And the second thing that I think about is I should film this more regularly, because I filmed one that it was 3 months update from January to March, and this one I'm filming right now, which is the 1st of August, and I have it filled with empties. Here you have a lot of makeup artistry things, which are mostly lashes, but the rest of the products that I will show you here are personal things that I use on the daily and that I've been just working through, because I know from certain categories I just want to have one of each. So if you want to see this empties video, I have a goal to finish $2,000 this year worth of beauty product empties. I don't count only makeup, I count skincare, I count body care, I count hair care, and I always count them because these are luxury things to me. So if you want to see this and see the products that I will repurchase and that I will not repurchase, or products that I found replacement for in my collection, mini reviews of products on this empties video, then just keep on watching. Okay, so I'm gonna start with this one. This is a cocoa lotion by Pink. I wouldn't repurchase, these are nice, but I prefer the Nivea body lotions. These were a gift from my aunt. I love the packaging with all the summery stuff. I have a backup of this one in another scent, like a grapefruit scent, and I don't buy these truly. They're gifts from my aunt. I basically never buy body lotion, and if I do, it's Nivea. This one, it's gonna be something that you will see as a repeat on my project, Deck of Panning Project Pan. This is the Pink Sweet and Flirty Body Mist. And this one, oh my goodness, it was such a hassle to finish. It still has a few uses left, like 2 uses left, but this bump I've been fighting on with it since the beginning of the project. I have about 6 body mists from Victoria's Secret that I need to finish. I already opened 2 other scents that I can use on the daily to finish them. And in the future, I will have 2 scents always, but I will never have 6 backups of these. But these are better for me than perfume, because perfume sometimes makes me sick. I just choose the vanilla, coconut, amber, and those type of sweet scents for an everyday. Oh my gosh, lashes galore. I have here the Kiss Look So Natural. I had to purchase these on Amazon, so these are a recent purchase and I will keep repurchasing. These are the 03. They are the ones that I go through the quickest because they are the most natural lashes, and my clients do not like drag makeup for them. They want more of a softer glam look, and they adore these. They look like a mascara, but better. So yeah, these I already repurchased, so I don't need to. The Wispies by Ardell are amazing. I have to repurchase when I go to the US, but I'm set with lashes right now. Then the Kiss Lashes in Page Boy, they're like a wispy, cat-eye type of lash. I have backups of this one on my makeup artistry kit. Then I have these Wispies. These are the Pro Lash 5-pack. These, if I find them at TJ Maxx and they're super cheap, I will buy them. I will not just look for the brand. If I find them at TJ Maxx or Marshalls, I will. And then the Ardell 811 Foaming Lashes. These are great for bridal. I don't have backups, but I don't care, to be honest. So I have a few packs of these ones, but if I have to recommend one brand of lashes to you guys, Kiss Lashes are the best ones. They're super light, you feel nothing, and they have every single lash that you can imagine, lash shape, that will suit different eye shapes. Garnier Micellar Water, this has been my go-to. I think Garnier recently became cruelty-free, but I'm super happy to hear about that. And I always buy the big bottles when I go to the US. I buy about 3 or 4 of them. I stock up, I send them in a box, and then I'm good to go for a long time. I use this for clients, but I mostly use it on myself. I use micellar water as a second cleanse every day, and then I wash my face, dry it, and start my skincare routine, I will repurchase this. And I have a backup of this one. It's already halfway gone. But since I'm going to the US, I'm not in any hurry to repurchase. One pack of Cotton Rounds. These I love. These I get from Amazon. I adore them. I will keep repurchasing them. And I'm using more and more my reusable Cotton Rounds. So I use these less and less. But I use these on my makeup clients and on myself when I need to remove something. And the reusable Cotton Rounds just swallow everything that I put on them. I would have to put so much micellar water to cleanse my face that I haven't found a way to use them that they will replace these ones that are just one-use Cotton Rounds. For my hair, I have here the Living Proof Restore Mask Treatment. These I finished, and at this point, I would have to repurchase another one. I prefer always the macadamia one. But since I didn't find that one the last time that I went, I always go to TJ Maxx and whatnot and buy two masks from macadamia. And if I don't find them, I will buy two masks of any brand because I don't use conditioner, but I use mask on every single wash. But a Colombian brand sent me a mask and it's huge. So I know that will last me for about 6 months. And now that I'm going to the US, I will buy two more for the next year. So I always have two hair masks in stock just for the entire year, and that will just keep working for me. If I can find the macadamia, that would be better. This was good, but it wasn't amazing for me. Okay, brow products right here. Like I said, 4 months worth of products. This one was the Gimme Brow in number 6. I used it for a long time and I was just stretching it out, stretching it out. This is a great product. I adore it. I've mentioned it in PR products that I would repurchase. I will leave that video linked below because I received, I bought one, then I got a few on PR, then I repurchased it and I got more on PR. These always come in PR and I'm not mad at it because I use it every day. I also have a brow routine that I showed you and I use the Gimme Brow. So I love this shade, and then I finish at 4.5, and I have my last 4.5 opened. So I finished these two because I was using them at the same time. Now I only have one open, and I know it will take me a long while to finish it, but these two have been open for so long because I was just going between the two back and forth. So they lasted about, for me, I think about 2 years. Yesterday, I finished my Laura Mercier brow gel. This just was on its last leg. It was just so dry right now. I adore this. I wasn't expecting to love a brow gel from Laura Mercier, but this is just wonderful. Now I have opened my Givenchy brow groom, which was a backup that I purchased, I think when I live in the US, or I don't know, about 3 years ago, I purchased that one. I don't know. It was just a long while ago, and I adore that. But the backup was just sitting in my collection. So now I'm gonna start to use that up. And then when I finish that, I will decide if I would repurchase this one or that one. Because I love the brow setter from Benefit, but the brush, I think I prefer this type of brush, which is a regular mascara brush, or the one from the Givenchy Brow Groom. I'm currently out of eyebrow pencils. So I have two here that I purchased on the last Sephora BIB sale. Not the one from this year, but from last year, the October one that I purchased. I purchased two number 4s from the Precisely My Brow. This is my favorite pencil. I would repurchase for sure. It's just that right now, I'm not in any hurry to do so. I was using first this one that I also finished. This is the Goof Proof pencil. This is the travel size in shade number 3. Not my favorite shade, it's too light for me, in my opinion. But now that I'm out of brow pencils, I will go and finish my ABH Deep Brow Pomade. So for mascaras, I found two right here. The Laura Mercier Caviar Volume. I have one backup. I adore this mascara. The first time that I used it, these two happened, the same thing happened with them. The first time that I used it, I thought I wasn't gonna love it. And then when it had about 15 days open and I kept using it and using it, I fell in love with it. And I already passed on about 3 of them, one to my mom, one to my sister-in-law, and one to a client that wanted to use the mascara that I was using. And oh my goodness, I regret it. I regret it so much. Because now I have only one backup that is the one that I will be taking to the US. I already packed it because I've been just preparing my travel bag for the 4 months, and that one isn't open. I miss it. I will purchase this. If I don't get it on PR again, I will purchase this for sure. This makes your lashes so, so huge and beautiful, but you have to give it time for it to dry a little bit to work better. And then a few days ago, I finished the Kevin O'Quan The Volume Mascara. And I have to make a video on products that I changed my mind about, because I have a Look Fantastic video from last year, I think, where they sent me a few Kevin O'Quan stuff. And I saw one of the makeup artists that works with them mentioning this mascara and how popular it was and how volumizing it was. And this is one of those mascaras that is a tubing mascara that you put water in it. It never budges, it never moves, but I thought this doesn't give me enough volume. You guys, if you let it dry out a little bit, you will not regret having this mascara. I used it for that video. I closed it and then I was thinking about using it. Like, I shouldn't use it. I don't love it. So it was closed for months because I used it only once and closed it. Oh my goodness. I didn't want to throw this out even though it's super dried out and it doesn't basically have any product in it. This is beautiful and it's one of the few mascaras that will never smudge on me. So I will repurchase this mascara for sure. Amazon lashes, these were so good when I started my makeup artist trick kit. Right now I will not repurchase. And I don't think I will ever repurchase. I prefer my Kiss lashes. So yeah, I finished another pack of these and I still have about 10 packs of these lashes. Like a lot of things I got, this is a gift from my mom or my aunts because they used to love the Dove Fortifying Ritual shampoo. I didn't like this, but I decided that I was not gonna buy a shampoo until I finished every shampoo that I had, like have gone or whatnot. So I decided to finish this. This makes my hair super oily and it felt nice, but it doesn't feel like my Rehab or my Milagros shampoo from the Colombian brand. Here I have the bottle of the shampoo Ultra Nutritivo from Milagros. I love this. This is amazing. I already repurchased. It's the one that I have in my bathroom. And I think this lasted about 7 months or 8 months using it every time I wash my hair. It's really, really nice. And I would recommend it if you live in Colombia and if you're watching this video, go and get it. This mask I got from Look Fantastic for February. I did a pampering video with them. This was one of my least favorite products. I saved half of it to use it on the next few days after doing that video, and then I don't know what happened that I didn't put it on my last empties video. This is the Yes to Coconut Ultra Hydrating for Dry Skin Moisturizing Mud Mask. This, I just didn't like it, and it made my skin a little red, so I wouldn't recommend it. Another of the pink products that you will see on my deck of panning project pan is the Squeeze of Pineapple Pink, like by Pink. I already told you I have backups of body mist, so I will not be purchasing any in the future, near future, but I will always have two body mists at hand because these are the ones that I use on the daily. This is the Dior Skin BB Nude. I have it in my Partners in Cream project pan. I don't remember, or in my deck of panning project pan. I think it's in my Partners in Cream project pan. You see it here and it's empty. But the truth is that I'm gonna count this as an empty, but I'm gonna count it in regards of a foundation. But the Dior Nude Skin BB Cream is on this bottle. And this is the product that I actually finished. This is the Pro Color Foundation Mixing Pigment in the shade White. I already repurchased, but I finished it completely. So I decided that I prefer this over this one. I'm gonna be throwing this out because it's empty. But when I finish this, I will count the money for the Dior. And now when throwing out this, I will count the money for the LA Girl that I actually finished. Another one from the Look Fantastic pampering video. This I finished yesterday. This is the Caudalie Beauty Elixir. I would repurchase. Oh my goodness. This is the second bottle that I finished. This was the travel size, but I finished the full size a year ago or 2 years ago. I love it. I find this to be so refreshing on the skin. Beautiful on top of makeup, beautiful underneath makeup, beautiful for on the go, beautiful to just pamper yourself with a mist that is minty and perfection, and the scent is just expensive. I adore it. I will repurchase at some point. Right now I have toners and things that I need to go through and I don't have the budget for it because it's pricey and it's a luxury product, but I truly, truly love this product. And I love that I get to finish this so quickly when I'm not a face mist type of person. Another Laura Mercier translucent powder that's leaving my collection. I have two backups of it, and I have one right now that I'm about to finish and that I'm mixing with another powder that I don't love so much to stretch it out. But Laura Mercier translucent is my favorite translucent powder, and it's my go-to day-to-day translucent powder. So even if I wasn't in their PR list, this is the reason why I think they found me, because this was my main product for my Makeup Artistry Kit and for myself. For translucent powder, this is just beautiful. It photographs beautifully. It keeps my oils at bay. I have it on my kit. When they released the deep shade, I purchased it for my kit, and now I have the honey, the regular translucent, and the deep on my Makeup Artistry Kit. So this sponge, it looks disgusting. It's been here for a while, but I made the mistake of just placing it on a clothes bag, and I forgot about it. Because I was traveling with it, so I forgot about it. I placed it in the bag wet, and then it got like fungus and stuff. So I will not be using it, even though it's not destroyed. So it's gonna go in the trash. And I like the Real Techniques sponges, but right now that I'm using a Beauty Junkie sponge, I think I prefer that one better, or the Beauty Blender instead of the Real Techniques, but they all work. So yeah, this is going in the garbage. Laura Mercier Purifying Micellar Water. I think this is my second bottle of this one. If they send it, I will use it up. But I don't know the price of this. I will just see and find out. I think it's $30-something. And it comes with 6.8 fluid ounces. And then the Garnier one, this comes with 23.7 fluid ounces. And these I get for $14 minus coupons. So yeah, I will keep repurchasing the Garnier, even though I really like the Laura Mercier one, unless you have more money to use on this type of product. For me, even though it says that it has a lot of benefits for your skin, micellar water is not one of the products on my skincare that I would invest. I will keep repurchasing the Laura Mercier eye cream instead of this for sure, because that's my go-to everyday eye cream. This is a brush cleaner by Color Beads. I will reuse this packaging. It will serve me well for my Makeup Artistry Kit, but the brush cleaner sucked. This is from the brand Color Beads, again, a Colombian brand. It was just really bad. Then the Purity Made Simple Cleanser. I've been working through all the cleansers that I have. My favorite right now is the Laura Mercier face wash, the foaming face wash. And it's so comparable to the frothy face wash from Origins. So I will keep repurchasing those two instead of this one. These, I just didn't love it so much. Even though it's a simple cleanser, I still prefer the other two that I mentioned. So I finished my Super Goop and Sin sunscreen. These lasted since October last year till now. Basically, I finished this about a week ago and I squeezed it completely. So yeah, I adore it. I will repurchase when I go to the US. Right now, I'm using a tinted moisturizer and a protecting primer that has SPF in it instead of buying an SPF that I will not love. And I will buy the bigger size so that it will last me a year, and that way I can repurchase it every October with the VIB sale. Foundation that I finished, this is the Too Faced Peach Perfect in the shade Warm Beige. I would use this as a bronzer, as a mixer. I just needed to finish it because it was getting super old. I really loved this foundation, and I have one shade that I need to finish soon that I need to put it on my Makeup Artistry Kit, bronze my clients with it, because I don't want it to go bad. This was a great value, great foundation. I just know that they are putting this line out, which I don't know why. It was one of the best things that Too Faced came up with, but I'm happy that I finished this one. And if you see this sticker, these are products that I put as a private goal to finish them without showing them in project pans. So then another foundation that I finished, and it was a foundation that had basically this amount of product. I was just in need to just finish it completely. This is the Dulce de Leche The Huda Beauty, the first foundation that she released, the Fall Filter Foundation, is discontinued right now. I still have two shades to work through. This is sentimental for me because the client and friend of mine that I went to law school with, that I purchased this foundation for because she wanted me to do her makeup. She was my best makeup client. With this foundation, she's the reason why I have different shades because I would mix them to get her perfect shade, whether she was tan or not. She committed suicide when I disconnected from YouTube, so it was really hard on me. I bet it was harder on her family. I miss her a lot. So yeah, this foundation, it just makes me think about her. That's why I pulled it out. And I have the other two shades, and I don't know, you guys, I don't know. It's a lot. I will never forget her. I have her on pictures for every makeup look that I did on her. I think I've never done so much makeup on one person like I did on her. So yeah, she will be missed. And this foundation reminds me of her. So I thought I'd mention her, but another foundation gone. Those are three foundations gone from my collection, and I have a fourth one here. This is the Estee Lauder Double Wear in 1W2 Sand. I will keep the pump for another Estee Lauder foundation that I have. I carry about 10 of these on my kit. This one I will repurchase, but every time I go to the US, I try to see if I can find them on sale. I will get them on a CCO to get them half price or whatnot, because every dime that I can save for my makeup artistry kit, I will do it, since all of my products are high-end. But this is the best foundation out there, in my opinion. And as soon as I finish the amount of foundations that I have on my personal collection, I will buy one of these for my personal kit, since I don't have it anymore. This is the Laura Mercier Concealer, the Flawless Fusion Concealer. Another product that I changed my mind about, and I fell in love with it while using this one, because I was comparing it to all the other concealers that I have. The Huda Beauty, the Benefit one, then the Kevin O'Quan one. And this is definitely a favorite, I don't know. But I haven't been having issues with my dark circles lately. And this is perfect because it's super lightweight, it's creamy. I used to complain that it didn't have enough coverage. So this is a light coverage, and you can build it maybe to medium, but it's more light medium than medium coverage, and I love it. I have a backup that my grandma gave to me as a gift in another shade, but I love the shade 1N because it works with my skin when I have zero fake tan, and it also works when I have a fake tan or when I have darker foundations that I want to lighten. So I adore it. I even took the stopper out. I just wanted to finish it completely. I love it. I would definitely repurchase this concealer. For black liners or pen eyeliners, I finished the MQNY. This is the McQueen New York brand that I got from, what was it? Stylevana. And then also from, oh my God, I just blanked out on the name, but I will leave a link below. Because if you use the code Jordana in all capitals, you get, I think, 10% off, and they have amazing stuff. So yeah, this one I have a backup that I will take with me to the US now that I'm going for 4 months as my liner. I love these, and these are about $6. They're amazing. I will leave them linked below. And then I finished one of the samples of the Kat Von D tattoo liners. These, I have one open that I know I will finish before I go. I love these. If they have it always in samples, I will keep buying them. But you guys, I want to try the Natasha Denona one that it's unreleased. That's just something that I have on my wish list. Here I have the Laura Mercier Vibe lipstick. And this is the Velour Extreme Matte Lipstick. One of my favorite formulas of lipsticks that I have in my collection. It's comfy. It's like pillowy on the lips, but it's still matte. I had to scrape it to get every little bit of it out. I have it in vibrant shades. If you guys want, I can do a vibrant lip series or just lip swatches with the Laura Mercier ones that I have, because if you like bold colors, I have a lot of them and I don't use them that often, so I can show them to you. But Vibe, it was a staple for me. I adore this lipstick and I will repurchase. This is an old one and I ended up scraping the amount that I couldn't use on my lips anymore and place it on a little pan on my Busette palette so that I can mix with other lipsticks for clients. I love this lipstick. This was so good. I have a little bit here that it's coming on the sides, but it's the type of color that you see me wearing every day. But this was the shade When in Doubt, and they used to come in this black packaging. They were wonderful, and I had just a little nub of it, and I decided that it was time to finish it up, so I did. I will repurchase. This is one of those lipsticks that I finish organically while having a lot of nudes in my collection, which I've been finishing throughout the years. Samples, I'm gonna go through them and just throw them out. These are the Tom Ford Foundation, and this is the Traceless Soft Matte Liquid Foundation. Four shades came in here. I finished all of them. Oh my goodness, you guys, this was beautiful. I would think about purchasing this one if it wasn't so expensive and if I didn't have the amount of foundations that I had. Josie Maran Argan Oil, the light one. I'm not in love with oils and I prefer other oils over this one. Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I went through a packet of samples. The only ones that I didn't finish are the darker ones, and I put them on my kit to use them more. And I finished two packs of these samples, and I mixed them up and got my right shade. This is, again, a foundation that I would want to have on my 5 or 10 foundations when I finish all the foundations that I have that I don't adore. The Huda Beauty Fall Filter Foundation. I had this pack for ages, and it came with a primer and four shades of foundation. I finished them on my kit, a few of them, the ones that didn't match for me, and a few on myself. And then the primer I finished. These are discontinued, but still I wouldn't repurchase. These are so high coverage that they wouldn't work for me. This is the Triple Thread Split End Remedy. These are not enough for me to form an opinion. Then the Playa Everyday Shampoo. I like this, but it wasn't memorable. Then the Briogeo Scalp Revival Exfoliating Shampoo. Again, it wasn't memorable, but I've been just trying to go through all of my samples in my collection and if not, give them away. Another one of the Cotton Rounds, gone. I've been trying to go through the Stila Glitters, and these two, one looks super empty because I dragged out every little bit of it, and it was beautiful, but I think this was limited edition, or I don't know if you can find the full size, the Painted Lady one. This is one that has duochrome in it. It's completely empty. I finished it about 3 days ago. I loved it. I just wouldn't purchase this anymore. I would have about two shades that I would use regularly, and that would be it, because I'm trying to finish them before they all dried up. This one, again, super dried up, and this is in the shade Stylish, which was a light gold. But it doesn't come up of the tube. It comes up dry and it doesn't stick to my eyelids. So these two, I'm gonna consider them done. I use them quite a lot. It's just that they get dried up super quickly. These, on the other hand, took me forever to finish, and I enjoyed every little drop of it. These are mini size that they sell from the Benefit Benetint, the red one. Oh my goodness, I would buy the pink one, the Chacha Tint, and this one, and I would have them because those are the type of lip products that I use. And these lasted so long. I use this every single day, and it lasted forever. So I would highly, highly recommend it. I would repurchase. The Perversion eyeliner by Urban Decay. This was a gift from Valerie, a subscriber of mine. Thank you, Valerie. I love this eyeliner. This is one of the favorites that I have for black liner. I still, if I get it, I know I will finish it. It's so creamy, so black, so beautiful. But I still prefer my Rimmel Scandalized in the shade 01 Black, because it's the same, basically, in a lot of ways. It doesn't budge. It's beautiful. And it's about $3 to $4 when these are $24. So one gloss. Oh my goodness. I don't know how Steph finishes so many blushes. If you don't know her channel, I will leave her link below. She's amazing. I always do my makeup listening to her. She's super funny. But she finishes glosses like a crazy person. This is the Buxom Sandy Lip Gloss. It takes forever for me to go through lip gloss. And I love this formula. I still had a little bit left. So I love this formula. These and the Fenty one are my favorite. So I have a few right there that I'm planning on finishing up. And then maybe at some point I would have one nude from Buxom and two from Fenty, and that would be it for my entire collection of glosses, because glosses give you basically the same finish, cut around packages. So these for 4 months, so four of them for 4 months, that's good. One a month, it's amazing. Two more lip products. This is the Rare Beauty in the shade Nearly Neutral, and this is the Balm, I think. Oh my goodness, I love this formula. It doesn't come up anymore, but this was so stunning on the lips, and the formula is so comfortable. It's one of those lippies that makes me want to buy a lippie, and a few things do. They don't move me as much as eyeshadow palettes, but I think I would purchase these. This was really nice. This one, I have a backup of it, and this was, I think, on a project pan. This is the Makeup Forever in the shade 3C. This is one of my favorites. I adore it. I have a backup. I love it. I would have 1C, 2C, and 3C always in my makeup collection. Okay, so I have here these two mini lipsticks that I had gone completely, but they had a product inside of them, so I decided to put them in my Boosted palette. So they're finished. This is one of my favorite colors. This is like patina, but on a drier matte lipstick bullet formula. This is Androgyna, I think it's the name. This is the Rouge Armani matte lipstick in the shade 102. Beautiful lipstick. Beautiful. I would repurchase this lipstick. And then this one, I finished mixing it up with other lipsticks to lighten them up. This is from Kat Von D, when it was Kat Von D only, and this is the shade Célèbre Tarte. And this was a mini one. So again, when the knob was right here, it was dome. I placed it on my makeup artistry kit, so I'm considering this one an empty again. Finish a primer, the Glow Maximizer Primer by Dior. Maybe I could cut it. I don't wanna see this anymore. This was so glowy. I had to mix it with body creams. It was starting to smell bad. When I first used the most of it, I was applying it on my face and then it went bad. So I started to apply it on my body with my body cream. So yeah, it's gone. I know this is discontinued. It was super pricey, so I wanted to finish it. But I wouldn't buy any glow primers for me. I have the Luminous Primer from Laura Mercier for my makeup artistry kit, and that's enough. I just don't go for glowy primers because of my oily skin. So you guys, last but not least, I have a lot of samples of perfumes, and I know I started doing a mini project pan and I never did an update on it. So I'm gonna talk about the ones that I finished. I basically don't remember most of them. I just wanted to tell you. So I have the Gucci Guilty one, then the Replica Coffee Break. This I remember and I would purchase. This was so wonderful. The Chanel Coco Chanel. This gives me a headache, but it's beautiful. It's a beautiful scent. Then the Tokyo Milk Dark in Pretty Rotten. This I loved as well. It's my type of scent. Desire by Dolce & Gabbana, the one. Gave me a headache. La Vie Belle by Lancôme, love it, gives me a headache. Then the Guerlain Aqua Allegoria, don't remember it. The Replica Jazz Club, I prefer Coffee Break. Burberry Her, don't remember it. And then the Cartier Baiser Bowl. This one, I don't remember. But I'm pretty sure that the Cartier ones give me a headache. That's about 10 mini samples of perfume. So yeah, these are gone and I have a few that I need to work on, but I'm not buying perfume in the near future. Okay, you guys, so that's it for this long ass video. I'm gonna leave here the total amount of products that I finished so far, and I'm gonna add it up to the amount that I wrote down on my last empties video. And then I'm gonna put here how short am I to reach my $2,000 goal. I don't think that I've reached it, but if I did, I would expand that goal for $3,000, and I know that I will because I've been finishing a lot of products lately, and I've been just working on products that I have on this little bin right here as products that I want to finish, and I've been just consistent with them. So that's it, you guys. If you love this video, please leave an emoji below that's a trash can or something related to empties or trash. And I love you, you guys. That's it. I guess I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.